Today we are looking at the last portion of scriptures concerning the Lord's Supper or communion. This is 1 Corinthians, the first letter of Corinthians to Corinthians, chapter 11, from verse 17. Is Paul talking about the Lord's Supper and what he calls order at the Lord's Supper? But in the following instructions, I cannot praise you, for it sounds as if more harm than good is done when you meet together. First, I hear that there are divisions among you when you meet at church. Then it talks about when you meet together, verse 20, you are not really interested in the Lord's Supper. For some of you hurry to eat your own meal without sharing with others. As a result, some go hungry while others get drunk. What? Don't you have your own homes for eating and drinking? Or do you really want to disgrace God's church and shame the poor? What am I supposed to say? Do you want me to praise you? Well, I certainly will not praise you for this. For I pass on to you what I received from the Lord himself. On the night when he was betrayed, the Lord Jesus took some bread and gave thanks to God for it. Then he broke it into pieces and said, "This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, he took the cup of wine after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant between God and his people, an agreement confirmed with my blood. Do this in remembrance of me as often as you drink it." For every time you eat this bread and drink this cup, you are announcing the Lord's death until he comes again. So anyone who eats this bread or drinks this cup of the Lord unworthily is guilty of sinning against the body and blood of the Lord. That is why you should examine yourself before eating the bread and drinking the cup. For if you eat the bread and drink the cup without honoring the body of Christ, then you are eating and drinking God's judgment upon yourself. That is why many of you are weak and sick, and some have even died. But if we would examine ourselves, we would not be judged by God in this way. So, what is Paul talking about? You remember that when Jesus instituted the Lord's Supper, when he started teaching his disciples communion and making it into something, a ritual that they should do afterwards. It was part of a meal. It was the Passover meal, and after the meal, Jesus took some bread, broke it into pieces, shared it, and then he took wine, shared it, saying, "This is my body, this is my blood." And this is the way it was done in the church. In the first church, we could see that it was part of a meal. It was what we call sometimes a love feast. People brought food and drink, and it was supposed to be shared. You know, each one brings something. In the north of England, they call it Jacob's joint. You know, where you bring, each one brings something, is bring and share. But instead of sharing, the rich people in the church were having their own for themselves, and they didn't care about the poor. The poor ones, the poor members of the church that had virtually nothing, were eating their crumbs together, and there was no sharing. There was no love. There was no real communion as part of that love feast. And then when people were reenacting the Lord's Supper, it didn't mean anything again. That's what Paul was talking about. So he started by talking about that meal that, instead of being shared, was just like each one to himself. And then at the end he said, if you share the body and blood of Christ by faith, as instituted by Jesus Christ, but you don't show love to each other, you are not eating together, you are not one together, then you are drinking your own condemnation. And the reason is that we take the bread, we share it, it is a symbol of what we are is just one loaf, one bread, and we are each one a part of it. So we share in the body and blood of Jesus by faith, but we also share as one with each other, because the church is the body of Christ. So we have to recognize the body. Recognizing the body means you recognize that you by doing that, by taking communion, you affirm and acknowledge and renew your commitment to the church as a member of the church, as a part of the church of Christ on earth. And this is absolutely essential. We cannot be lone stars, meteors that go our each one his way. No, we are part of the body of Christ, and we have to recognize the body. As we do that, we cement our union with each other and with Christ. We say, Lord, I am yours, and I'm yours in the church, because we are not alone. It's not an individual exercise. We are part and parcel of the church, and everything we are is within the church of God, the church of Jesus Christ. Well, I'm not talking there of our local church or our denomination, or is they are just like parts of the church of Christ on earth. And so taking communion is saying, Lord, I'm yours. I renew my commitment to you. I renew my commitment as part of the church. I am one with my brothers and sisters. And if we don't recognize that, then we defeat the purpose of communion. We make a mockery of it. And that is why God said that we are going to be disciplined. And I want to invite you, to encourage you that we are going to commit ourselves to the church and to Jesus Christ as we take communion together. Bless you.